Let us sing this morning number 202, 202, Holy, Holy, Holy. Holy, 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 Lord God Almighty, early in the morning our song shall rise to thee. Holy, 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 merciful and mighty, God in three persons, blessed Trinity. Holy, 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 all the saints adore thee, casting down their golden crowns around the glassy sea. Cherubim and seraphim falling down before thee, which wert and art and evermore shall be. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, the grace and the peace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with you all. Beloved brothers and sisters, today the Dominicans, we offer this Mass for all our benefactors, the anniversary of our benefactors who've died, and all who have been our friends throughout the centuries and the long life of the Dominicans, and hopefully many years to come. So let us now enter into the solemn mysteries on this Labor Day, asking pardon for our sins, as we say, I confess to Almighty God and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts, in my words, in what I have done, and in what I have failed to do, through my fault, through my most grievous fault. Therefore, I ask, Blessed Mary, ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life. Lord, have mercy. Christ, have mercy. Lord, have mercy. Let us pray. O God, giver of pardon and loving Arthur, author of our salvation, grant, we pray, in your mercy, that through the intercession of Blessed Mary, ever Virgin, and all your saints, the brothers and sisters, friends and benefactors of our Dominican order who have passed from this world may attain a share in eternal happiness. We ask this through your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever.
A reading from the first letter of St. Paul to the Corinthians. Brothers and sisters, it is widely reported that there is immorality among you, and immorality of a kind not found even among pagans, a man living with his father's wife. And you are inflated with pride. Should you not rather have been sorrowful? The one who did this deed should be expelled from your midst. I, for my part, although absent in body, but present in spirit, have already, as if present, pronounce judgment on the one who has committed this deed. In the name of our Lord Jesus, when you have gathered together, and I am with you in spirit, with the power of the Lord Jesus, you are to deliver this man to Satan for the destruction of his flesh, so that his spirit may be saved on the day of the Lord. Your boasting is not appropriate. Do you not know that a little yeast leavens all the dough? Clear out the old yeast so that you may become a fresh batch of dough, inasmuch as you are unleavened. For our Paschal lamb, Christ, has been sacrificed. Therefore, let us celebrate the feast, not with the old yeast, the yeast of malice and wickedness, but with the unleavened bread of sincerity and truth. The word of the Lord. Lead me in your justice, Lord. For you, O God, delight not in wickedness. No evil man remains with you. The arrogant may not stand in your sight. You hate all evildoers. You destroy all who speak falsehood. The bloodthirsty and the deceitful the Lord abhors. But let all who take refuge in you be glad and exult forever. Protect them that you may be the joy of those who love your name.
The Lord be with you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Luke. On a certain Sabbath, Jesus came into the synagogue and taught. And there was a man there whose right hand was withered. The scribes and the Pharisees watched him closely to see if he would cure on the Sabbath, so that they might discover a reason to accuse him. But he realized their intentions and said to the man with the withered hand, "Come up and stand before us." And he rose and stood there. And Jesus said to them, "I ask you, is it lawful to do good on the Sabbath rather than to do evil, to save life rather than to destroy it?" Looking around at them all, he said to him, "Stretch out your hand." He did so, and his hand was restored. But they became enraged and discussed together what they might do to Jesus. Dear brothers and sisters, the Holy Gospel of the Lord. Well, the work of the church, since we're on Labor Day today, the work of the church is to bring healing, is to bring salvation to people. St. Paul would say, to do so with the unleavened bread of sincerity and truth, to really have the motives of bringing goodness to other people. And so the miracle that Jesus works on the Sabbath in the synagogue, which enrages the Pharisees so much because they want to do away with him. But this miracle that he does is restores a man his hand is a withered hand, and he says, "Stretch out your hand," and in the midst of them all, his hand is cured, which gives him work, which gives him the ability to work and to be a better breadwinner for his family, take care of his family. So there could be a parable we could make with this day today, Labor Day. Now, of course, the labor movement in the United States started at the end of the 19th century during the Industrial Revolution, when workers were working 12-hour days, 12-hour days, 6 days a week. A worker would get up, not even see his children or her children, and then they would be asleep. By the time they came back from work, the children would be asleep again. The only time they would see their children would be when they're asleep in bed. And so it was very discouraging for the workers, and the rates at which they worked were getting smaller and smaller, and people were being demanded to do more and more, and it became too intolerable for them. And so these marches and these demonstrations began. A famous place, one place I visited this summer in outside of Chicago, Pullman. Pullman was one of the industrial, the railroad industrialists, and he made these Pullman cars, and he had workers there, and it was there that they started one of the first labor demonstrations. Another one was in Ohio, in one of the steel towns, where there was a very violent encounter between the protesters who were workers trying to get 10-hour days, from 12-hour days to 10-hour days, and then. And then in the 20th century, from 10 hours to 8 hours, and make things livable. Well, anyway, the work of the church is a work of justice. It's a work of bringing salvation. God's call to people to embrace with sincerity, St. Paul says, with sincerity in truth. These are the motivations. And for St. Paul, in this letter to the Corinthians, he has to confront the community in Corinth with a very serious problem, where one of their members is a man who is living with his father's wife. We don't know her name. I think her name was Saucy Trollop. Anyway, she seemed to be comfortable with that arrangement, but St. Paul wasn't, and I'm sure it was uncomfortable for the Christians too. And St. Paul says, even the pagans, they have better taste and morals than that. They don't, they respect marriages, and they don't go living with their father's second wife or third wife or whatever. And so St. Paul tells them, you are to deliver this man to Satan. Doesn't that sound so strong? And our tendency is to say, well, that's a terrible punishment for St. Paul to do. But it's not meant to be punitive. It's meant to be therapeutic. It's meant to be a way for St. Paul to bring this person back. And the only way you can turn this person back is to send them out. You've broken off your morals, our morals, and so you must leave this community. We tend to be less confrontative in these days with people, but St. Paul, of course, he didn't like doing something like that. That wasn't really St. Paul's manner. St. Paul really loved, his communities, and he tells them, I thank God every day, for you and for all that you do for him, for me, St. Paul would say. And so St. Paul had to do this work, to weed out somebody, and in order that person would then hopefully would repent and come back and would return to the very call that Jesus makes to us. He calls sinners, not those puffed up with pride. The puffed up with pride people, with pride, just bursting out of every part of them, and their words, and demanding and feeling entitled to everything, and having more than other people. That is not the role of the Christian community. And St. Paul you know, calls the whole community to work with him in bringing somebody so that they may meet Jesus again as for in the humility of asking for Jesus's mercy, which God freely gives, and but for those only who truly repent and who ask for it. So we conclude this reflection on the readings on this Labor Day, and we ask that the church may be renewed as always in the great work of bringing Christ's salvation to the world. And let us stand and let us pray. So we're praying for the deceased brothers, sisters, and benefactors of the Dominicans, and so that Jesus, who is our resurrection and life, may give peace forever to all who have died, we pray to the Lord. Amen. That all people of this world of ours may never lose sight of their eternal destiny, we pray to the Lord. We pray that all bereaved and sorrowing may find comfort in the belief that death has no power over their loved ones. We pray to the Lord. And that the Eucharistic presence of the risen Lord may be our pledge and support as we journey through life, through death to everlasting life. We pray to the Lord. We pray for our Holy Father, Pope Francis. We pray for our Archbishop Jose Gomez and for our Auxiliary Bishop Alex Aklan, who I hope to see today. We have a clergy dinner luncheon over at San Fernando Mission at the offices over there. I hope that he'll be feeling good enough to come and meet the priests who are offering him your prayers and the prayers of all the communities here as they pray for him. We pray to the Lord. And for all our private needs and prayers, which you now bring to the Lord, we ask God in silence for all our special needs. We pray to the Lord. Almighty, loving and caring God, help us to grow in faith and love so that we see the death as our birth into the kingdom of heaven. Prepare our hearts to accept this truth. Grant that the faithful departed find the faithfulness and the fullness of peace which you alone can give, through Christ our Lord. Amen.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation. Through your goodness we have received the bread we offer you, fruit of the earth and work of human hands. This will become for us the bread of life. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation. Through your goodness we have received the wine we offer you, fruit of the vine, work of human hands, that will become our spiritual drink. Pray, dear brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. O God, whose mercy is beyond measure, receive with favor our humble prayers, and through the sacrament of our salvation, grant to the souls of our brothers, sisters, friends, and benefactors, whom you granted to confess your name, remission of all their sins through Christ our Lord. The Lord be with you.
Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere, to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. In him, the hope of blessed resurrection has dawned, that those saddened by the certainty of dying might be consoled by the promise of immortality to come. Indeed, for your faithful, Lord, life is changed, not ended. And when this earthly dwelling turns to dust, an eternal dwelling is made ready for them in heaven. And so with angels and archangels, thrones and dominions, and all the hosts and powers of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glory as without end we acclaim. Holy, 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 Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, and giving thanks, he broke the bread and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice. And once more giving thanks, he gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. Save us, Savior of the world, for by your cross and resurrection you have set us free. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly, we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit.
Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, Jose, our Bishop, and all the clergy and ministers of your people. Remember our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, the Mother of God, and the Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles and martyrs and saints, our Holy Father Dominic, our Sister Catherine of Siena, Saint Lorenzo Ruiz, and all who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through Christ, your Son, our Lord.
Through him, and with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. Amen. At the Savior's command and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come. Thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. The kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Lord Jesus Christ, you said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you." Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. Amen. The peace of the Lord be with you always. And let us share with one another and with love the sign of Christ's peace. Peace of Christ, peace of Christ. Thank you. The act of spiritual communion. My Jesus, I believe that you are present in the most holy sacrament. I love you above all things, and I desire to receive you into my soul. Since I cannot at this moment receive you sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. I embrace you as if you were already there and unite myself wholly to you. Never permit me to be separated from you. Amen. Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I'm not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. You are rest after toil, O Lord, life after death. Grant them eternal rest. Let us pray. Grant, Almighty and merciful God, we pray that the souls of our brothers, sisters, friends, and benefactors for whom we have offered this sacrifice of praise to your majesty may, through the power of this sacrament, be cleansed of all their sins and receive from your mercy the happiness of eternal life through Christ our Lord. The Lord be with you. The peace and blessing of Almighty God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit descend upon you and remain with you forever. Go in peace. Let us sing the last two verses of number 202, the last two verses of Holy, 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 number 202. Holy, 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 though the darkness hide thee, though the eye made blind by sin, thy glory may not see. Only thou art holy, there is none beside thee, perfect in power and love and purity. Holy, 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 Lord God Almighty, all thy works shall praise thy name in earth and sky and sea. Holy, 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 merciful and mighty, God in three persons, blessed Trinity.